Hello, MechWarriors! How is it going? Welcome to your daily dose of MechWarrior Online. Today, guys, we are playing the Piranha, and more specifically, the Cypher, which is the Hero Piranha. I really wanted to play this mech once more, because I haven't tried the laser, mini laser vomit and machine gun combination yet. Now, what are we doing? We have 5 heavy small lasers and 4 ER micro lasers to open up the enemy's rears, and then we're gonna unload a barrage of machine gun fire into their open component. The idea is again to just have that big alpha strike in super close range to just remove the armor and then get the critical damage going with the machine gun. So it's a nice combination of lasers and machine guns. On top of that, compared to the full machine gun build, we don't run out of ammo. So even if we run out of ammo, we have some lasers to back us up. Another cool thing is that we have, again, the 5 heavy smalls, which is the maximum of heavy smalls that you can fire at the same time. But since PGI changed the weapon group so that the ER micros have their own weapon group now, they don't generate a heat penalty, so they don't get into each other's way. You can fire all of them together, and that is really, really good. We are going for the maximum engine here, 180, because I want to be fast, I want to close distance real, real quick. And yeah, that's basically it. 2 tons of machine gun ammo, 6 machine guns, and that's what we are doing today. The skill build looks like this here. We have invested into the firepower tree, and I wanted to go for the laser duration and then heat gen and cooldown. We have 1 point of magazine capacity here, and I think that's enough because we have already a ton per 3 machine guns, and this will just give you some longevity in the long run. But yeah, it's all you need. You don't necessarily need to go for the second magazine capacity if you are, you know, a bit conservative with your shooting. We don't use survivability here, but we have a bit of kinetic burst and heartbreak just to give us quicker acceleration and deceleration, just to adapt to the aim of the enemy. If they are tracing your movement, you just stop real quick, let the shot go wild, and then accelerate again to just run away. We are also going for maximum cooldown and maximum heat containment because we are still an energy-based build, and that will generate a lot of heat over time. And I want to be in the face of the enemy as long as possible, therefore getting the cooldown and the heat containment so that we can alpha strike more often, and we are not relying on our machine guns only, but also the lasers. Then we go for radar deprivation and double seismic sensor and a double cool shot and double artillery situation here. I hope you have a lot of fun in the 2 games that are coming, and if you have that, don't forget to leave a rating or subscribe to the channel if you haven't already. And now it's time to hit the battlefield. Alright, first game of the day. We are playing the Crimson Strait. We are playing Conquest. And we have 2 disconnects today. I mean, at the very least, it's even. But, oh my god. What am I gonna do here? I am trying to backstab somebody. So I really hope that nobody is here at the saddle. If so, we're gonna kill them, right? Because we are Piranha. We are a fierce opponent that can actually... Oh, that's a Black Lanner. Streaks, no thank you. There's a Streak Black Lanner on the saddle. He has Streaks and machine guns. And a heavy laser. I don't want to go up against Streaks. Instant retreat. Instant retreat. I don't know. If that guy got luck on me, I would be very damaged. Maybe even dead. So, I'm gonna peek again. Is he still here? Is he still around? Let's keep that forward. Yeah, he's still here. He's still there. Shall we overwhelm him, guys? Shall we go in? Yeah, let's do it! Come on! Show yourself, you filthy Black Lanner. I'm gonna push the Black Lanner. I don't know if he's if he knows that we are here. If he's aware of his position that he's in. I'm not engaging yet. Actually, he's faster than me? No, he is not. I want it to be in optimal range, and then we're gonna go with, actually, lagging. Oh, he needs to turn. He doesn't turn, he's dead. He doesn't turn. Okay. He needs to. Come on, slow your movement. I cannot follow him up. Now he turned around. Okay, it's fine. The Black Lanner turned around. He's aware. So I'm gonna pair up with my Arctic Cheetah here because the ECM will definitely help us. And don't worry, guys. We are a late game mech. We will have our time. I was, trying to backstab the guy, but it didn't quite work. So, what do we have? That's a Warhawk with an Ultra 10, ER medium lasers, and 2 SRM6s with Artemis. Okay, just to know, it's good to know that we have that on the field. The Lanner is coming in, Delta 7, Delta 7 hot. There it, oh, no, it's legs on the Arctic, sorry, Wolfhound. Legs on the Wolfhound, legs. Let's go. Hello? You're gonna go for my legs, probably. I need to outrun him here. And down he goes. Wanna stay behind him. Okay, cool. Nice job, Mr. Cheater. I'm pretty happy that we had somebody around. I'd probably not be able to outfight him. The Wolfhound would have killed me. He had too much armor for me alone. That's what Wolfhounds have. A lot of armor for light mechs. Okay, that's gonna be enough. Assault mech in Charlie 7. Assault mech in Charlie 7. What is that? A Battlemaster. Alright, let's go in his back then. He seems to be very static. Okay. I'll take it. Was he disconnected? Naive Warrior? I don't know. Oh, that might have been the disconnected guy. I don't know. Probably. Alright, we'll take it. We'll take it from here. Now, we are you have 4 kills already. So my team is wrecking on the other side of the battlefield. And you know what? We can be a little bit overly aggressive. And that's a weird thing to say, I know. A little bit overly. Mm-hmm. That's what we want. There's the Lanner again. Come on, buddy. Come on. I'm gonna finish what I started. Let's go for it. And now the Atlas. I'm not even afraid of the Atlas. Especially since he's running LRMs. Down he goes. Very good. Who's that? There was one guy here hiding in the buildings. It's not really hiding. Ow. You have SRMs. That hurts. And the lasers for the side torso destruction. And then the shutdown. And the follow-up. Problem is that I'm a little bit hot right now. So, let's cool down. Let's scuttle our way up here. No, we couldn't. We were pushed down the ramp. What I'm hoping for now is that the enemies are... Ooh, wait. Are dropping. As their last resort. We're gonna wait here. We're gonna await them. Maybe. Maybe not. Maybe not. Probably not. Okay, so we have to push up. Let's go. There's one assault mech left. There is a Lima, a Banshee. And then there's also one light mech. So let's see if we can hit the Banshee a bunch. The Banshee a bunch. I'm completely in his back and he is... He has basically nowhere to run. That's the Ruck Banshee. Oh, wow. He's good with his aim. But his Rucks are down now. Gonna do this once more. Gonna go with the machine guns in his back, shoot the micro lasers to open him up a bit more, get the kill, perfect. And I should probably be going by now. Alright, rifleman dropped, and I am down to 30%. I mean, yes, but still, we did a good job here. Wait, there's still a light mech. It's a Cypher as well. He's running ER smalls and... Wait, a lot of ER smalls and machine guns. And down goes the rifleman as well. Pretty good round. Nice reaction to the comms here. I liked that. And yeah, we got it with the Cypher. First round, let's have a look at the end score. And then we go over to the next one. We got a nice number here. 777 damage dealt. We got 3 killing blows, 5 assists, and 4 kill most damage dealt with 7 components. As I was saying, first round is over. Let's go over to the next one. Alright, the second game of the day. We are playing... We are playing a Flea. Look at that Flea. Am I gonna go for the Flea? I probably have more DPS than him. Oh, he's running small pulses. That could be devastating for me. But I could be devastating for him. So, let's see. Maybe we can hunt him down. We have some more light mechs coming with us. And actually, I wanna see what we can do. We cannot do anything against the big guys in the first phase of the game. So, let's try to do something against the light guys. He's out. He's out. You know what? I will go over here to Echo 5, because I know that in Echo 5 the fight will happen, and maybe we can amplify the damage when my team is fighting, and, you know, go in, do something. Osiris, he's probably very damaged already, because he was poking our front line. Yep, down he goes. No, it's not him. It's not him that is going down there. And he's actually not that damaged at all. Okay, so one poke. We don't need to do anything more than that. Hello. Hello, good sir. Hello, Vindicator. Yep. You and your heavy PPCs have no power here. Except I'm blocked. I don't know if I was blocked by my light mech buddy here or if I was blocked by terrain. But I didn't want to go in there. Dude, they have friends. Actually. Let's go for this guy. That's worth a cool shot, definitely. I should also stay in motion. And I should stay in kill range. Come on, down he goes. Perfect. This was the Vindicator, right? Yep, he is. Oh, no, 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 you made him turn around. Am I dead? I need to make sure that the arm is not pointing at me. The arm, the right arm, is where the PPCs are sitting. And the big question is, am I gonna run into a full firing line now? I don't think so. Okay, he's XL. And he has no power here. Because his PPCs are on the run. Down he goes. 3 and 2. I need to cool down before I do anything. So, let's wait a second. I don't need to go anywhere right now before I'm completely cooled again. Also, ammo is still okay-ish. Where to go? Yeah, let's follow the fleet to the right side because I believe we have assault mechs there. Let's see. They are probably in the high ground, Delta 6. Going in with the flea. Oh, crap. Don't block him. Don't block him. Okay, now they are watching this. Okay, let's go for the next window. Wow, my flea is going balls deep here. Okay. Let's go. On the Jaguar, on the Jaguar, on the Jaguar, on the Jaguar. Oh, no. Gauss rifle. Let's try to destroy side. Let's try to destroy the mech. DPSing him. Okay, got him. Out, DPSing even. Oh, flea. We have a stealth flea in our midst. I should not go for him, actually. Guys, there's a stealth flea shooting us. Okay, I cannot go for it. We need bigger targets, guys. We actually need bigger targets. And I need to go. Ah, my leg, my leg, my precious leg. I dropped artillery. That's what I was going for there. I really hope that they are running into it. No, not quite. Okay. But we have a nice forward momentum from this angle. Maybe we can help out. If my big guys are going in first, they will attract the fire. And we are helping out with good DPS. Like that. Just like that. Okay. I don't know what that is. It is dead. That's important. That's the important part of it. That it's dead. Let's go for the back of the Annihilator. Can we? Yes, we can. Down he goes. Sorry. Sorry, sorry, sorry. And there's an Osiris trying to run away from us. One shot and we have him. Yeah, everybody wants him. Everybody wants him. You know what? No. No. Yes, no. Ah, let's go for the other guy. Somebody else can take the Osiris, no problem. Man, everybody's so greedy. Everybody's like, oh, I want that kill. I want that last guy off the battlefield. It's an assassin. Running into the team now. And wow. Am I gonna die here? The greed? The greed self-destruct? Yeah. It is the greed self-destruct. Was necessary. Ah, you want all the kills. Give it to me. My hunger is still there. Okay. Now, that was a fun round. We had 3 killing blows, 5 assists. We had 3 killmoss damage dealt with 779 damage and 8 components destroyed. My mech techs will be very mad at me, but hey, I was having fun. If you had fun in the video, then don't forget to leave a rating or subscribe to the channel if you want more of this. If you want to support me, go down below to the description. There is the link to my Patreon page, and I hope to see you guys on the battlefield. Goodbye.